favorite boxers. And he's the one of the big reasons I start training boxing. My last fight was in May 20, Fantasy Spring. And my opponent was a Sapo too. So I learned too much about that. I didn't fight like 2 years before that fight. So that was so exciting. And I'm more excited right now. I'm a main event fighter, so it's more responsibility. My opponent name is Diego, and I watch a few fights of him, and I follow him. I know what I have to do in the ring. This Friday, my fans, like, except to see like action fight. I will try to end the fight before the 10 rounds. Yeah, my training camp start like almost 2 months, and it's already enough time to be in a great shape. So I'm ready for this fight.
Main event in the ring. There you see Art Lionheart Hovhannisyan. Glendale, California, 34 years old. Hovhannisyan took this fight a couple weeks ago. This was originally supposed to be Fidel Maldonado, the Golden Boy fighter, the Trisco kid from New Mexico, taking on Diego Magdaleno. Fidel never signed the contract. Robert Diaz, the Golden Boy matchmaker, thought that they had a deal going. They're going back and forth. They agreed to it. The contract was never signed. They move forward. Hovhannisyan jumps in. Magdaleno is here. Two fighters, guys, that have a lot on the line. It might be one where the loser might just time to go home.
Well, the winner advances and does bigger and better things, especially for Diego Magdaleno, who's been a perennial contender for about the last 4 or 5 years. But, Doug, that's the ironic thing about the sport of boxing. While Hovhannisyan is the late replacement, it doesn't necessarily make him the easier fighter. I think stylistically, if you look at their history, Hovhannisyan's a little bit more durable than Fidel Maldonado.
Exactly.
He might have ended up with a tougher fight.
Maldonado had the youth, the speed, and the power, but he's also a reckless guy at times.
Damas y caballeros, esta es la pelea estelar de la noche. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, our main event of the evening. 10 asados en el peso super ligero. 10 rounds of boxing this scheduled in the super lightweight division. Presentada por Oscar de la Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions y patrocinado por Cerveza Tecate, Born Bold, Carmelita Pure Coconut Water y Casa Mexico Tequila. It's in the taste. Los tres jueces por ese combate, the three judges scoring this bout at ringside, Carla Caiz and Hall of Famers Marty Denken and Dr. Lou Moran. When the action begins inside the ring, your referee in charge, encargado de ring, el referee, Jerry Cantu. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready, and the fighters are ready. Ciudad de Los Angeles, dile al mundo, make some noise if you are ready! Presentando primero la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos blanco, rojo, y un peso de 137 libras. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. Wearing white, trimmed in red, he weighed an officially 137 pounds. Un veterano de 30 peleas, su récord 28 victorias, 2 derrotas y 12 ganadas por knockout. This 35 veteran has 28 victories, including 12 knockouts, and just 2 defeats. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Diego Magdaleno. Y su oponente en la esquina roja, con los pantaloncillos negro con dorado y un peso igual de 137 libras. His opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wears black, trimmed in gold, and he too weighed in officially 137 pounds. Con un récord de 17 victorias, 2 derrotas, 3 empates y 9 ganadas por knockout, this veteran of 22 bouts has 17 victories, 2 defeats, 3 draws, and 9 wins by way of knockout. From Glendale, California, he is Crazy A. On Hovhannisyan! Once again, Jerry Cantu with the final instruction.
2 seconds, let's go. Poppy, gentlemen, you are giving your instructions in the dressing room. I want a good, clean, hard fight. You will obey my commands at all times. Touch them up, good luck to both of you.
Jerry Cantoon, third man in the ring. Let's look at the tail of the tape for this fight.
At age 29, Magdaleno 5 years younger. Hovhannisyan 1 inch taller. Magdaleno with a slight reach advantage.
We had that Twitter poll all night long. Earlier it was Magdaleno with 80-20. What are the latest results? Did you see the bout sheet? Oh, we'll get you those results. Art Hovhannisyan. Hey, easy. Put your name, Art, on the trunks. Heat right on the belt. Glendale, California, 17-2-3. Last time he was in the ring was supposed to be the guy who was the main event tonight, Fidel Maldonado. A split draw to Fancy Springs Resort and Casino. Diego Magdaleno, 28-2. The two losses have been when he went up for the WBO titles. One time in China, another time in England, and the loss to Terry Flanagan, it was the second round. That's one where everything that went wrong could have gone wrong. He was stopped in the second round, has not fought since. Some talk of maybe not even coming back. Excellent article by Steve Kim on UCN Live about Magdaleno's return to the ring, Steve. And he was very open and honest with you.
Basically, he's had a pretty good career. He's been on big stages, fought in exotic locales, big arenas, been a part of big cards. But there's one thing missing. And I know a lot of people say it's easy to win a belt, but if you really look at it, there's less than 100 fighters in the world that could actually say that they are world champions. There's thousands of guys out there plying this trade. Mathematically, and you look at the percentages, it's not that easy to win a world title. And to be very frank, at 135, right now it's a very deep-loaded division. It will be an uphill climb for Diego Magdaleno to win one.
And I tell you what, if he can't get past Art Hovhannisyan, I mean, Hovhannisyan is a gatekeeper. That's what he tells us. If you can beat him, it means you're legit. Maybe you are a top 10 contender. If you don't, if you can't beat him, it means, you know what? You're not really going to be in title contention.
After the loss to Flanagan last year, he had thoughts, Magdaleno, of actually joining law enforcement and making that his career. He said he's just had a little bit more left. Still just 29. He felt as though if he quit now, he'd have regrets years later.
Diego Magdaleno started boxing at the age of 8. Why? Because he couldn't punch anybody in soccer. He was a soccer player. Didn't really like it. But next to the soccer field was a boxing gym. Finally convinced somebody to take him to the gym. After that, he was hooked. He used to watch, as good Mexican kids do, watch the Chavez fights, the pay-per-view, Oscar De La Hoya, all that other stuff. He said boxing is just what he loved the most. Like soccer, but being able to hit somebody helps. Opening round between Hovhannisyan and Magdaleno, our main event from the Belasco Theater, scheduled for 10 rounds, 10 good rounds. Sold out, it's hot inside the venue. Bodywork from Magdaleno.
Magdaleno has found a home for his straight left from the outside, right on the belly of Hovhannisyan. And he's looked pretty good in this opening round for somebody who's been away for 1 year.
Final seconds of the opening round. Let's find out some more information about these two fighters.
Diego Magdaleno, Steve, as you mentioned, he's 29 years old, so he's still in his athletic prime. 2007, he was a U.S. amateur lightweight champion. He's held minor belts of the WBO. He's the older brother of Jesse and Marco Magdaleno. And as you noted, Jesse Magdaleno is going for the 122-pound title on the undercard of the Pacquiao-Vargas fight. Hovhannisyan turned pro in 2006. He is a 10-year pro. Four-time Armenian amateur national lightweight champion. And this is his second fight back after a two-year layoff. And although that was a disappointing split draw to Maldonado because he thought he won, it was a good fight for him because he knocked off a lot of ring rust.
And there you see the Golden Boy logo in pink. Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Keep using the hashtag RingTV. And you know you got some dedicated fight fans when you're watching at a wedding. Right now they're doing the dollar dance. Veronica, Jose, Sosa, and Osvaldo, forget the baile del dólar. They're actually watching Ring TV. Let me show you guys this picture right here that I just got the text. That's when you know you're legit fight fans, and we got a good scrap coming your way, Veronica, as Diego Magdaleno and Art Hovhannisyan are going to go at it. Magdaleno, the southpaw. Doug mentioned the older brother of Jesse and Marco. There are three sisters, three brothers, as they are from a fighting family. Jesse will take on Nonito Donaire on the undercard of Pacquiao and Vargas. Right, he's actually here in attendance watching his brother. Hovhannisyan, the southpaw, is expecting his first child. Trains with Joel Diaz in Coachella, the Indio Boxing Club. Lives in Las Vegas, but for camp, he comes down with Joel, where he lives with four other fighters. And when you're with four other fighters, and you're a married man, that's when you're dedicating yourself to this craft. But you have to do that.
It has to. This is a must-win fight, I believe, for Diego Magdaleno.
Hovhannisyan, a fighter known around Southern California boxing gyms. Just that, tough guy, isn't he? Just gonna stay right there with
him. He's Armenian tough, Armenian proud. He has a good amateur background, just like Magdaleno does. A durable guy, but as I've noted before, he has underrated craft and technique. He's having a hard time getting his punches to land against Magdaleno. Magdaleno has that wide stance, and he gets undershots pretty well.
Well, I get the sense with the advantage in athleticism and quickness that Magdaleno has, Hovhannisyan's going to have to work his way into this fight. I think whatever success he has is probably going to start to come in the middle round.
I agree.
You know, you look at Magdaleno with those trunks, some of which are really missing. He grew up watching Chavez, but he's really a Camacho
guy. Yeah, Camacho, maybe Sean Bay Mitchell, if you remember him.
Didn't you guys have a theory about these trunks? It just seems when you wear those,
you got to be kind of flamboyant. Yeah. You got to be a fast fighter. That was a nice left cross landed by Magdaleno. You're supposed to be quick and flashy.
Yeah. Mark Two Sharp Johnson, a Hall of Fame flyweight, he wore trunks like this.
Yeah. Both of them swinging wild here in the second. It's scheduled for 10. 10 seconds to go in the second round. Magdaleno, Hovhannisyan. Fighters literally fighting for their lives. As Los Tigres del Norte, Puerta Negra is jamming. Joel Diaz barking orders at his fighter.
And I need you to be a little more messy. A little more accurate. Okay, don't open wide.
Keep it tight, okay? Hit to the right.
Vamos, papa, you're doing fucking good.
He's just trying to land that right up, okay?
This is your night. Your defense is on point, baby. Your defense
is
on point.
Baby, you don't like body shots, acuérdate.
Hey, every time you hit him to the body, he don't like it.
Yeah.
Hay que seguirle picando el cuerpo, cabrón.
Okay.
Vamos.
Keep going to the body.
Take a deep breath. Go, baby. Go.
There's a left cross, followed by a right hook. Left on the inside, Hovhannisyan also cranking up a right cross on the inside. Missing with the right hook, connecting with the left to the body. Hovhannisyan kind of holding and hitting a little bit.
Third round of action, sold out Belasco Theater. Next time we're here, November 4th, Tino Avila from Northern California will be the main event. Emilio Sanchez from San Fernando will be the co-feature. And then December 17th, the Forum. So Lito and Miro right now, Hovhannisyan, Diego Magdaleno said they're really fighting for their careers. Joel Diaz said that he had a two-hour conversation with Magdaleno. Said that he's going to do everything he can to protect this fighter because he has a long future as a father and a husband. That he's not going to let this guy come in here and take any kind of abuse. Because Joel said he was very honest with him after the Flanagan fight. Hey, if you're even thinking of maybe retirement, you need to think long. You can't go in the ring and not be 100% mental.
Beto, Justin Fortune, best known for being the conditioning coach of Manny Pacquiao, told me years ago, a fighter that thinks about retired, in essence,
is retired. Yeah.
You know, great there line. Is that belief.
He's great mentally line. Checked out, yeah. he's just there physically, and you gotta have both as a prize fighter.
When you talked to Magdaleno, Steve, what was his attitude?
You know, I'll be honest with you. He was upbeat. He was not down about it. And it's been a full year since that Flanagan fight. Now, Flanagan is not a devastating puncher. He's more of a guy that puts the work in. I was stunned along with everyone else. It was such a short night for Diego Magdaleno, but he's still very, very hopeful. He did not seem to me like a guy who's just playing out the string with one foot out the door.
Well, it looks like he's dealt with whatever doubts a fighter is going to have being blown out in two rounds. It doesn't look like he's second-guessing himself in there. Seems like he's recovered psychologically speaking.
You mentioned the psychological. Joel was also telling me that for that fight, he noticed a different Diego in London. They were there the whole week. That Diego kept telling Joel, his trainer, I'm not sleeping. Well, the jet lag, no, he was up. He thinks he was thinking too much because he was in the process of buying a house. He wanted to please his parents. That money, a big payday, was already being spent. So maybe he doesn't feel like his focus was entirely on that fight. And being the oldest of the brothers, he's the one that's taking care of the family. He said, felt like he put too much pressure on himself in that fight against Flanagan, and the result showed.
You know, it reminds me of that old saying from Yogi Berra, and it certainly applies to boxing. Half this game is 90% mental.
Oh, yeah. Half of 90. Good body work from Magdaleno, the Las Vegas fighter.
But, Doug, I agree. Right now, I think Magdaleno looks very sharp, quick off the trigger, using his advantage and speed, and I think has won the first three rounds.
Yeah, he's not leery of pulling the trigger. He's not gun-shy at all. And that's something you look for when a fighter is coming off a knockout loss.
10 seconds to go. Third round. Scheduled for 10. Magdaleno Hovhannissian. Starting to heat up at the Belasco Theater in downtown Los Angeles.
When you walk them back, how do you feel?
Good.
Okay, can you walk them back?
Yeah.
Okay, sign up your fucking defense, walk them, let them throw. Y cuando te peguen, cuando te golpeen el cuerpo. He don't like the fucking body.
Yes. Ya no picando abajo.
Okay, pick it abajo.
Hit him, hit him
like
low.
Walk his fucking ass down. Okay?
Yeah.
Hey, he's trying to just land the fucking uppercut, Camilo. Okay?
Yep.
You're doing real fucking
doing
good.
Right.
Hey, you're doing real good. Take a deep breath, okay? Like I told you, this is your night. Don't lose that composure, Papa. You're doing really fucking good. All right? Vamos, Nico. Okay? Quiero bien vivo, cabrón. Okay? Vamos.
A lot of good words you can learn in Spanish right now.
Colorful language.
Yep. That is what you would call boxeo, right, Doug?
Yeah. You're
speaking boxeo in that language?
Well, absolutely.
That's the one thing I really respect about Joel R-rated Diaz. He truly is a coach.
He's passionate.
Coach.
Yeah, he's passionate.
It's
in
not a
rounds.
Kind corner.
No.
I think there are too many yes men in boxing more afraid of actually losing their job than telling the truth. I think the honesty of Joel Diaz, the brute honesty of Diaz, I think very, very refreshing.
And we'll see if Magdaleno can follow these orders. Right? Diaz wants him to push the Armenian back. Easier said than done, because Hovhannissian is very strong, physically speaking.
You know, and that's not really his game. Doug, look at his record, 28-2, 30 professional fights, 12 knockouts.
Yeah, he's a boxer.
So, you know, sometimes you have a Louisville slug or sometimes you have a wiffle bat.
As Joel Diaz, to that point, asked him, how do you beat Hovhannissian? He said, we pick him apart. Because he said Hovhannissian is just so dang tough, you have to continue, just chip away, chip away, chip away. As Joel Diaz, last week he was manager, this week he's trainer.
He went from the suit to the sweatsuit in week.
He's more composed as a manager. as a trainer, he is emotionally vested in his fighter, and you like to see that. Beto, in our last fight with Damon Allen, I think we both felt that Damon Allen's corner needed to show some passion and crack the whip, maybe as early as round six, because Damon needed to finish strong. Yeah.
Good work from Magdaleno. Hovhannissian right there shaking his head. Nope, Hovhannissian has a good crowd with him. Both. These are just two veteran guys pushing each other around. And one thing about Magdaleno, training with Joel in Coachella, he is the elder statesman. Joel has fighters that are 18, 19, 20 living in that house. And this is a grown man at the age of 29. This is different for him.
Sure, and he's the guy who's been to the big dance.
Yep.
He's the guy who's married, who's about to be a father. You know what I mean? He's the mature guy.
And I'm sure the young fighters in Joel Diaz's stable look up to him and learn from him.
As Joel Diaz said, he had a conversation with this fighter yesterday, told him very open, heart to heart, you're 30. It's hard to market you. Nobody wants to invest with you. Because after his fight with Flanagan, he was dropped by Top Rank, almost dropped by his manager, still with Frank Espinoza, has no promoter, was brought in as an opponent for Fidel Maldonado. That fell through, still here. As Joel said, if you want to continue your career, you have to open eyes.
Yep, and we
should know. Nobody wants the guy who is just there.
Exactly. Magdaleno is in the blue corner.
Yep, the opponent corner.
Yes, he's in the opponent corner.
Good right landed by Magdaleno. Jovanisci with the right of his own. 10 seconds to go.
Good action.
Good action indeed, Doug Fisher. Good jab by Magdaleno. Good four rounds in the books. And there was a clash.
There's Joel Diaz's team. That's a nice young stable. I see Oscar Duarte. I see Aguirre, who we just saw fight on the undercard today. The younger brother at the far right, Marco Magdaleno, who probably loves to fight more than anybody I've seen. There was a clash of heads. Do you see blood? Do you see a cut?
And it was a punch according to Jerry Cantu, the referee. That right there was a result of a punch. There was a clash, but he's saying it was a result of a punch. Jerry Cantu right on top of it.
So if this fight is stopped because of that cut, it is a TKO victory for Hovhannissian.
Because we are in the going to the fifth round.
We're going in the fifth round.
Yep, worked on it right away. Who do they have down as this cut man for Magdaleno?
It's Joel. Yeah.
Okay. So Joel has it down as a cut man.
Yeah, Joel has that bracelet with the little cup of Vaseline in it. Yeah.
Doing it all. Manager, trainer, cut man.
Cut man.
Yep. Southpaw is Diego Magdaleno. First loss came in 2013 for the WBO Super Featherweight title. That was in Macau, China.
That was a close fight. That was against Rocky Martinez, who was still in his athletic prime at the time.
Yeah, that was a good scrap. Check that out on YouTube the other day. Make sure you go to the Golden Boy YouTube page. Get all the fights you're looking for. If you're looking for the young fighters like Hector Tanhara, Joshua Franco, all these young up-and-coming Golden Boy fighters, they're on the Golden Boy YouTube page, the Belasco Theater, the fights at the Fantasy Springs, StubHub.
Beto, going back to that night against Rocky Martinez in Macau, I thought he was actually winning that fight going into the championship rounds, but just didn't have enough of a finishing kick. And physically, you know, one thing Magdaleno lacked, good right hook, is really power. And I think that's always going to hold him back and be his bugaboo at the world-class level.
And Hovhannissian is scrapping with him.
I see some blood
near
one of both. Yeah, it's over the left eye, and that might have come from that right hook that Magdaleno landed a moment ago.
Hovhannissian picking at that left eye. Going back to the eye is Magdaleno. And this is what Hovhannissian does. The times we've seen him, Doug, he gets hit, he sees his own blood, and then he attacks.
He answers. He doesn't shy away from a fight.
34-year-old Art Hovhannissian in the black. Body work from Magdaleno.
Guys, I can't recall a fight where Magdaleno was sat down on his punches the way he is tonight and really just turning with them. He is trying to put a little extra oomph on his shots.
Like nice. That. Short right uppercut.
Body work upstairs. Oh, another good body shot.
That was low. Yeah, because you can see Hovhannissian's belly button. So if you land like below the art on his belt line, that's going low.
Yeah, I saw Hovhannissian hunch over.
Yeah.
But I was blocked. All right.
Well, he's not pulling. His trunks aren't pulled up high.
Okay. And a good veteran move by Hovhannissian. Hold in.
Yeah.
Buy some time. 30 seconds to go in the fifth.
He's very physical and close.
Art comes to fight.
Yes, he does.
And he gets hit with that one. And he's wild right now. That's his own off balance, not from a punch. Cantu saying it was slipping.
Magdaleno can take advantage of some of these wild swings from Hovhannissian. Just has to time his shots right.
Blood from the left eye of Hovhannissian. Another good round for Diego Magdaleno. Imako's his nickname. IMA knockout. That's what he and his brother have in the back of their trunks.
Control now with your legs up it, okay? Sabatane. Artie, breathe deep. Take control. Your legs. Box it on. Sabat duano. Box it up. Control that on. Orsi box over the set. Tell us. You're great. Shot you chabatse, okay? All right, Artie. Good abatse, Artie. You're great, brother. Shot the best of them. Versa. Shot la foya. Don't worry. Bend your knees. Uppercuts and right away, okay?
The heads have come together. There's that sweeping left right on the belt line. But because Hovhannissian's trunks are not up high, that was a borderline low blow. And Diego, who is a knockout, was trying to go for the knockout in that round, tried to follow up.
Gary Cantu bringing his fighters into the ring, controlling him a little bit, a little bit out of control, a little wild. Hey, a lot on the line for these guys regarding their boxing future.
This is a high-stakes match.
Don't want to be relegated to contender status. Opponent status. Where Magdaleno is, wait a minute, what am I doing here? It's one thing to be an opponent when you have a belt on the line. Another one at a club show. Lionheart, he has that tattoo over his right chest muscle, does Hovhannissian. Right, good combination for Magdaleno. Good footwork for Magdaleno. Lateral movement from Magdaleno, really nice. Yeah. I know, Steve, you emphasize that a lot with young fighters, that lateral movement,
well,
that rope.
As they say, don't frame your punches and then don't take a picture. And one of the big advantages Magdaleno has is foot speed and the ability to move laterally after punching. And I think Magdaleno really has to be careful here. I think he's built the lead, but as these guys come together, their heads are starting to come very close to banging on each other more and more.
And their lead feet are stepping on each other's toes, and that's going to happen, obviously, because Magdaleno is a southpaw, but also he has a very wide stance.
Yeah.
But I'm impressed with the sharpness and his activity and his elusiveness as well.
And, Doug, what he's doing is he's making his elusiveness, his defense, turning it into offense. I thought with Damon Allen, I thought there were too many times. There's so much head movement. And there was nothing layered on top of that in terms of actual counterpunching as he let Arceo take the fight away from him.
And a lot of the question marks, Steve, you wrote in your column on UCN, how will Magdaleno come back after getting destroyed by Flanagan? The mental aspect.
Yeah.
This doesn't look like a fighter who is thinking right now.
You know, he looks like a fighter that has a real sense of urgency. Again, he is not a power puncher. I can't recall a fight where he's loaded up on so many of his shots as he has tonight.
I've never seen it.
Doing research for this fight, you always go back and look at some of the previous fights. He looks different.
Yeah.
Like, he has a little bit of a swagger to him tonight.
And one thing I think he has to be very mindful of, they're going to get into exchanges. He's the more technically sound guy. He should just keep the emphasis being a little bit shorter and a little bit more compact with his punches. When he's wide is when he becomes vulnerable.
Makes you wonder what Fidel Maldonado was thinking not signing this contract.
I know what he was thinking. I need more money for this type
of
risk.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Steve, Kim's opinion. No, but I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because this dude is coming in hungry and ready to steal something from you. Final seconds of the round is scheduled for 10. Hovhannissian and Magdaleno going at it in LA.
Especially when he's frustrated, he's swinging from every angle. Away. Okay, try to get inside with your tight defense and hit him in the body. Hurt him to the body and then switch it on him. Okay.
Magdaleno cranking his right to the body, trying to bring the hook up to the head. Stays low and gets under hooks and crosses from Hovhannissian. Staying out of range, landing his jab. Going to the body with both hands. was a good round for Magdalena.
Doug, that's a beautiful job of moving your head, stepping back, and then resetting with offense.
Seventh round, scheduled for 10. How do you have it, Doug?
You know what? I have six rounds for Magdalena.
Really?
There have been some competitive rounds. Really, most of these rounds have been competitive. I was close to scoring round four for Hovhannisyan, but I just think that Magdalena has been a little bit busier. He just landed cleaner shots throughout this fight.
Doug, I have it exactly the way you do. Six rounds to nothing, 60 to 54. Sharper, cleaner, more effective punching from Diego Magdalena.
Magdaleno slipped a little bit while in his corner. There was some water there, and I noticed that was a problem against Terry Flanagan in that ring in Manchester. He was slipping and sliding all over the place, never really got started in the fight.
I'm not saying that's why Flanagan blew him out. I got to give Flanagan. He's 30-0 for a reason. The guy can fight.
The Flanagan side will say he kept slipping over left hands.
They're not wrong.
Joel Diaz said that this morning at breakfast. He told Diego Magdaleno, you have to be a risk taker in this fight. A loss will have you done. He used the analogy that boxing is a fire. If you panic, you're going to die. You have to stay composed because of the type of fighter that Hovhannisyan is, because Hovhannisyan wants to get you into that firefight.
Absolutely. Joel Diaz is right on the money, and of course he would know. Post he challenged for a lightweight title himself. He was a fighter. He has experienced every aspect of this boxing game.
You told me a good story last week in India. He's like, you know about those sort of Mexicans everywhere? I'm like, really?
No, you don't say.
Yeah. He's like, I fought in Johannesburg, South Africa, and there was two of them, the last row, and I brought them into the dressing room afterwards. He's like, I fought for the world title. He's like, dude, I look up, and there's a flag. I ran and told the usher, bring them to me.
That's great. I think that was Philip Holliday that he fought for the IBF title.
Yes, it was. Here he's watching his fighter, Diego Magdaleno, in the white and red.
Hovhannisyan having a little bit of a rally here.
Hovhannisyan is tough. I mean, if you're a manager and you take a fight with him,
you know your guy's not going to have an easy night.
As Fidel Maldonado didn't have, he was split draw last time in Fantasy.
Nobody has an easy time.
And Hovhannisyan had a two-year layoff over there doing MMA also. Glendale Fight Club. Nope, he did not go down, was hit. Looked like his glove might have got it, but no, he stayed on his toes.
The glove was close to the canvas.
Another good round for Magdaleno. It looks like he's even stronger, too, as the fight progresses. Final seconds of the round, do it for seven.
See here, so Hovhannisyan off balance. I couldn't tell if that left touched. It might have grazed, it may have. Yeah, the left glove may have grazed the canvas. If it did, and had Cantu seen it, that could have been a technical knockdown at the referee's discretion.
Reverse angle.
Get another look. Jab. The left hand hit the right shoulder of Hovhannisyan. It did.
Oh.
Yeah, he needed that left hand to touch the canvas to stay upright. That could have been a technical knockdown.
It was on the opposite side of referee Jerry Cantu. Very tough to see, but not for ring announcer Joe Martinez. He's got 20/15 vision after paying for it. Eighth round. Diego Magdaleno looking good. Still have a shutout, guys?
I do.
Body work from Magdaleno.
You know, and with that said, Beto, I'm not seeing Diego Magdaleno do the Dean Smith and go into the four corners. I think his tack tonight is that if he's going to be aggressive, he will quell some of the effectiveness of Hovhannisyan. So I'm not so sure he's going to actually retreat here. I think he is going to try to do exactly what he's done for the first seven rounds and just be real steady with this pressure and then explode with certain combinations. Do some real nice work out of the corner here.
There are a lot of eyes on him, aren't there?
Right. Well, I mean,
when you have nobody on your side, no promoter.
Right. Well, if you look at Diego's record, 28-2, he's a recognizable face. He's challenged for world titles. He's got a nice looking record. The lightweight division is deep. There are fights to be made, and not everyone's going to face each other at the same time. And if you have a manager like Frank Espinoza, who told me earlier this week he's constantly on the phone looking for opportunities, a win here tonight, it's not inconceivable within a fight or two, Magdaleno gets another significant opportunity.
This fight was agreed to at 137, super lightweight division. Polynesian is just tough. I mean, you can win every round against him, but you got to earn every single second.
He remains undeterred. I thought he had some opportunities when he had Magdaleno's back against the ropes in the first minute. Really wasn't able to capitalize on that, though. And that was to Magdaleno's credit. He cranked up the body shots and backed him off.
That's something the young Golden Boy prospect Damon Allen could be watching this. How Magdaleno going upstairs, downstairs, continuing to use it, and Steve not taking his foot off the gas pedal in the last couple rounds.
Allen had a learning experience, and see, Magdaleno, he's a more mature fighter. He's farther along.
Watching it while you guys were with the executioner, I thought early on, Damon did not realize Luis Arceo didn't play by the script.
No.
This was a real fight that he got sucked into.
Damon Allen with the draw. Everything else tonight have been the first three fights were KOs. Marcela Cornejo had a unanimous decision. The co-feature had a draw, and here in the main event, Art Hovhannissian and Diego Magdaleno going at it with less than 30 seconds to go in the eighth. Oh, good body shot upstairs does go Magdaleno.
Magdaleno, he's not content just a jab from the outside.
Yeah.
He's gonna throw power shots.
Using those Sabas gloves, a little pop in them. Left hand, final seconds of the round. Timekeeper doing a good job getting those loud clappers going. Everybody can hear it.
I'm unfamiliar with Sabas gloves.
Yeah, they're kind of an off-brand.
Where are they manufactured?
I really don't know.
You know,
Mexico. Gloves,
Mexico.
Yeah.
I mean, I assumed they were Reyes.
No.
Just looking at the design and looking at how, you know, the shape of them when he makes a fist.
This guy cannot hurt you no more. The only way he can hurt you if you get reckless.
Yeah.
Hey, I want you to walk him down. Can you do that?
Yeah.
Can you do that? I want you to walk him down. If you can, tell me. If not, let me know.
Yeah.
But I need you to walk his ass back.
I'll do both.
Okay. Is he hurting you with the punches?
Yeah.
Nice brown.
I'm going to do both.
Is he hurting you with the punches?
No.
Okay. Come on, hey, tighten up your defense and make him go back. Cortito, pero don't let him hold you.
Okay.
Okay, and hurt him nothing to the body. Walk his ass back. Let's go back.
Yeah, Sabas gloves out of Southern California, a new brand. A lot of the young Mexican fighters really like them because they do the custom color for him. So, family-owned business.
He is color-coordinated. Those gloves match his socks.
And, guys, love the instructions from Joel Diaz. I think the trainer realized the only way Hovhannissian now can land the Hail Mary shot is to by coming forward. So what do? You halt the momentum. You draw a line in the sand, and you do just enough punching to dissuade Hovhannissian.
And Magdaleno is punching in the right places to halt any sort of momentum Hovhannissian is trying to mount here. He's going to the body.
You know, I've said in the past, Magdaleno is not a hard puncher, but you know what? He's still a professional fighter who throws sharp, fast punches. And if he hits you enough times, he will discourage you.
You do have to respect his punches. Can't just walk through it.
You know, one time I was interviewing Paulie Malignaggi, who was really a slick boxer. Again, you see Magdaleno doing good work, and I asked him, are you a hard puncher? And he says, no, but at the same time, even if I hit you as a pro fighter, it doesn't tickle. So there you go.
He's right. I believe him.
Magdaleno continuing with the pressure, continuing to control the ring.
Take the play away from Hovhannissian.
Hovhannissian breathing heavy now here in the ninth round.
I'm sure some of those body shots had something to do with that, Beto.
Took the air right out of the tire, Doug.
Hovhannissian took the fight a couple weeks ago. And because Magdaleno was training for Fidel, who was a southpaw, they had to change the entire camp the last couple weeks at Joel Diaz and Diego Magdaleno.
Doesn't seem to be affecting him at all.
Huh?
I mean, Magdaleno has had the perfect game plan. I've never seen a fight this one-sided against Hovhannissian.
That's true.
Alejandro Perez beat him, but it was still a competitive fight. It was still somewhat close on the final scorecards. It was a unanimous decision for Perez, but it wasn't an easy night for Perez. And you know what? This isn't an easy outing for Diego Magdaleno. Even if he wins by shutout, those scorecards, he had to work for it. It was a hard-earned shutout, if it is indeed a shutout on the official scorecards.
Bovanesian has gone the distance in every single one of his fights. The two losses, 2013 against Alejandro Perez, you mentioned it, Doug, and then a split decision loss to Jonathan Mycelo. As the draw is coming in early in his career. Foul swing and a miss from Diego, uppercut.
Magdaleno, this second half of this fight, I think, has been really masterful in running Hovhannissian into his punches, just taking a half step back, making Hovhannissian come forward, and just timing him perfectly, specifically with that straight lead left and the right hook.
Final seconds of the round, the ninth, the Belasco Theater.
Hey, I'm really impressed with Diego Magdaleno. I'm impressed with the commitment to his offense throughout this fight.
This fucking round, let's go, baby. You're winning the fight. The fight is no doubt you won the fucking fight. But I need you to close in fashion. Okay? No tiene para estimarte. Spit. Spit out. Diego, cierrame con lujo, papá. Can you do that? Can you do that? Can you apply pressure and stop this fucking fight?
Magdaleno cranking a left to the body. Working his jab, coming over with a sweeping left that he misses with. Hovhannissian leans away from it. Gets caught with the left on the ear. Hovhannissian does, tries to return fire.
Tenth and final round between Diego Magdaleno, Art Hovhannissian. Great sportsmanship between the two in the middle of the ring. And then they go at it. Joel Diaz said finish with some shine. Asking for his fighter to come out. None of the stay away. No D. Smith, as you said, Steve. Come out. Put on a show. Finish with the show. Close it with a show.
I get the sense Joel Diaz realizes what he has in Magdaleno, that in future fights, because Magdaleno, again, doesn't really...
He doesn't have world-class power.
Right, but and he's not that slick where he's not Pernell Whitaker.
Right.
He's going to have to be a jockey that continually goes to the whip and really be hard on his guys. Because you know what? You look at the Rocky Martinez fight, which I think that's more or less what Magdaleno was. I think the Flanagan fight to a certain degree, I don't want to say it was a fluke, but it was an aberration. You have to continually ride this guy to the finish line hard.
And I tell you what, when Magdaleno was active in there, gets it done. I mean, he's looking like a solid lightweight. Now, is he he's not a top five lightweight. Is he a top 10? Arguably. Top 15. I would put him, you know, between 11 and 15 in there with his experience, with his ability.
Be a tough out for one of those young up-and-comers with an undefeated record.
Right, and he doesn't have elite athleticism or natural talent, but he's solid all around.
The name also.
Yes.
Not a high-profile name, but it's a name where you're like, okay, if an up-and-comer can beat him, get by him. Oh, good body work.
Yeah.
Oh, I double roll.
Good leverage on those body shots, although he gets his right arm trapped in the ropes. And they're sportsmen. They touch gloves. Get right back to the punching.
Good right from Magdaleno. He's doing exactly what Joel Diaz told him. Put on a show.
I love the body attack. I love the commitment to his offense, but particularly to the body throughout this fight. Yeah.
The whole night he's gone to that body.
Well, he's worked. He's worked in every round. He has not taken a round off.
Or even a minute.
And I don't think you can do that against Hovhannissian. You do that, you open the door for Hovhannissian to come on.
Good action from the opening bell between two professionals, Bernard Hovhannissian and Diego Magdaleno. More body work by the lefty from Las Vegas. Soon to be father of a baby. Had the baby shower a couple weeks ago.
Oh, good work
from Magdaleno. Just even get in there against Art Hovhannissian is tough. And land a shot like that would be more impressive here late in the round. 10 seconds to go, and what has been an exciting, superb fight between two tough, rugged fighters.
Wow.
And they finish it like champs, like pros. They go the distance. A good scrap between Diego Magdaleno and Art Hovhannisyan. We'll be back with the results from the Velasco Theater in downtown Los Angeles on Ring TV.
Okay, Mom, bye. My mother's coming to live with us. Your man cave has got to go.
Honey, it's gonna take you forever to sell all this.
Sold.
What? How? Honey bun!
Sold another one.
Introducing the easiest way to sell what you got, buy what you want.
Bye!
5 miles, download the app today.
Honey, Mom's here.
Just a minute.
Decision, Diego Magdaleno!
Unanimous decision for Diego Magdaleno. He improves at 29-2. I think you guys had him sweeping the card. I think the judge.
I had it
a
shutout, 190. It was hard fought, well earned. I think Magdaleno can still be a player in a very deep lightweight division, Steve.
You know, what do I say all the time? It's not if you win, it's how you win. And I thought tonight, I don't want to call it a statement victory, but he showed that guy right there still a little bit more gallop in that horse.
A good night of action at the sold out Velasco Theater in downtown Los Angeles. It all started with Maricela Cornejo. 6 rounds of action against Eliza Olsen. La Diva, originally from Washington, improves to 5-2. She got the unanimous decision. A good opening bout in the super middleweight division. Promoted by Pepe Gomez, Cancun Boxing. And there you see it with her manager behind her. And then the co-feature from Philadelphia, Damon Allen and Luis Arceo. And Allen, the youngster from Philadelphia, he's 24 years old, 10-0, ran into a veteran. The reason that they're called journeymen and gatekeepers, because they come in and give you a scrap. And Luis Arceo from Aguascalientes, now living in Tijuana, the man who sells mariscos, well, he served up some experience to Damon Allen tonight, as Damon Allen draws with Luis Arceo. Bernard Hoskins was here ringside. Go and check out that interview later on. Real talk between those two in our main event. Diego Magdaleno, Art Hovhannisyan, two fighters with a lot on the line, trying to figure out who's going to continue the professional boxing career. Magdaleno looked good after a year layoff. Sweeps the card. The fighter, Imako, Las Vegas, trained by Joel Diaz at Coachella, is now 29-2. Probably working his way back toward a bigger fight. For Oscar De La Hoya, president and founder of Golden Boy Promotions, a Hall of Famer for David Tetrault, Executive Vice President, Scott Tetrault, Vice President of Golden Boy Media Entertainment, Will Wright, Vice President of Golden Boy, leading the way tonight for my partners, Doug Fisher and Steve Kim, and everybody involved with the broadcast tonight, the backbone of Golden Boy Productions, Media and Entertainment. Thank you very much. Good night. I'm Bethlehem Duran.